So please understand how you lost the land. And don't think just because still some Hindu temples are running and people are going to the temples and coming, the Hinduism is alive. Be very clear. If you just even read the history 100 years before, the number of people percentage getting initiated into Hinduism and studying Hinduism, either in Veda Padashala or Saiva Siddhantam or Vedantam or Smarta or Gaudiya Vaishnava, anyone sampradaya of Hinduism, how many people used to take up Hindu studies 100 years before? See the percentage and see the percentage now. Without any doubt, I can say, now, people who take up studying Hinduism full time is practically negligible. Zero point zero 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 zero, maybe one. One in the last. Just few sadhus and few people in Hindu Gurukuls, that's it. People studying full-time Hinduism is almost killed, eliminated, destroyed. I met another one, religious leader, a top person in Brazil. When I traveled to Brazil, it happened few years before, maybe 10 years before. Top person of that country, a different religion. So we were having conversation. He was very friendly. After 10 minutes of conversation, he suddenly revealed that he is from Tamil Nadu and Tirunelveli district. He started talking in Tamil and I was very happy to know that he is from Tamil Nadu. And he told me he reads my articles in magazines. In those days I used to write in Tamil magazines articles. And then the conversation became very friendly and very cordial. And 3-4 times he came to meet me. He's a very top person in his religion and hierarchy level. He's the topmost in the hierarchy, in his religion, in that country. So, casually I was talking and he was also telling about what the activities they do, everything. And I said that I have a training center for monks and around 100 monks are studying in India, and every year I am expecting to graduate 100 people into monks and nuns. He said, Swamiji, I have a training center in Mumbai. I have 12 units only in Mumbai. Each unit has 3,000 people every year. Around 30 to 35,000 youth graduate as nuns and monks and preachers from my unit, Swamiji. Whole India, after thoroughly studying various sampradayas, Ramakrishna Mission and Chinmaya Mission and Bhagavan Swaminarayan's BAPS Sanstha and ISKCON and various sannyas sampradayas, I am telling you, none of us have sannyas training institute where thousands graduate every year. Yes, all of us have sannyas training institute, no doubt. Hundreds maybe. Never 4-digit number. None of us have 4-digit number graduating every year. The amount of hatred, hate speech done on Hindu sannyasis, Hindu monks, Brahmins, the Hindu lifestyle after independence in India by mass media cult and entertainment cult has taken away the confidence of Hindus on Hinduism and studying Hinduism full time for living, practicing and preaching. Understand? The Neo-Hindus, last two generation Neo-Hindus, they even developed a strong hatred on the whole Guru Parampara. That is the greatest achievement of the mass media cult, entertainment industry cult. One of the biggest milestone they reached in eliminating Hinduism. The Neo-Hindus, the anti-guru Neo-Hindus are as dangerous to Hinduism as anti-Hindu elements. Because the Brahmin hatred and guru hatred is enough to eliminate whole Hinduism.